DAX offers you two functions to compute calendars. They are calendar and calendar auto. The result of both functions is just a table with one column containing dates in the boundaries that you specify. If you use a calendar, then you need to provide both the start date and the end date in order to obtain a good result. If you use calendar 2005, from the 1st of January 2005 up to the 31st of December 2020, you see that you have all the dates starting from 2020 and it will go down up to 2005. Calendar requires you to specify the boundaries. There is another function, calendar auto, that does everything automatically. It scans the entire model looking for date columns in your model, and it creates a calendar that starts from the 1st of January and goes to the end of December of all the years which are referenced by any date in your model. If we use calendar auto, you see that we have dates that start in 1910 and they will go down to the last sale. Now, there are no sales in 1910, but among the many dates, calendar auto found also the birth date. And because we have customers that were born in 1910, the calendar generated by calendar auto is pretty large. That is why you probably will need to filter the result of calendar auto to reduce the size of the table that is generated, unless you really want all those dates in your model. Calendar auto accepts also an argument that is the end of the fiscal month. So if you specify 6, meaning that the fiscal month starts in July and you run it again, you see that now the calendar does not start on the 1st of January, but it starts at the beginning of the fiscal year. The fiscal year is still complete, so it will go from the first to the last date of the entire fiscal year. Let's see an example of usage of these functions. You can use calendar auto to create a simple calendar table to add to your model. Calendar auto generates only the date column, but then you can use other functions like year, quarter, format, or month to extract part of the date and build a calendar table that contains the year, the quarter, the month, and the month number. By modifying this code and making it more complex, you can easily generate your own calendar table.